My name is Nestor Espinoza. I'm an assistant astronomer here at the Space Telescope Science Institute, and I work for NASA's James Webb Space Telescope. My role within the Webb mission is an astronomer within the near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph, NIRISS, which is one of the four science instruments on board of Webb. NIRISS, the near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph, is an instrument that is very versatile. It can do many things. So first of all, the name says imager. So it means that this instrument can take images, like pretty pictures of space out there. The important part also in the NIRISS name is the very first part, which is the near infrared. So infrared light is a little bit weird to us humans because we cannot see it. So the beautiful thing of Webb is that it allows us to actually see into these colors that are invisible to our brains. We can capture them with these instruments. And NIRISS in particular captures very detailedly one region of that infrared set of colors that allow us to see the universe in a whole other dimension. My career journey has been very interesting. So I was born and raised in Chile, in South America. And over there, I didn't know that you could be a scientist until I was like a teenager. It was actually my physics teacher, I think, was the biggest influence here. So she mentioned to me that a scientist is a career and that you can develop that in college. And I was astounded at the possibility of, like, you know, being paid for doing scientific discoveries. It was like a dream come true. So my scientific journey started from there. And I guess the first step there is to talk to other people, and in particular, talk to other people with more experience than you, which was my case, speaking to my physics teacher. Sometimes opportunities reveal, like this one. Then, while I was in college, the same story kind of repeated. Like, I really wanted to work in exoplanetary science, for instance. That's the one that kept my attention locked on astronomy. But I didn't know exactly how to do this. And I know of a professor, which then turned out to be my grad school advisor, that he was doing some exoplanetary science. So I just went to his office and knocked and said, like, do you have a project that I could work on? Because I'm really excited on this. So again, ask. I think that has been like a repeated part of my journey as a scientist. It's like just not staying still. I'm trying to look for those opportunities out there because they are out there.